I'm never there to convince someone anything because this is impactful. So I didn't always have the confidence that I have in this or in other things that I've done. Because when I truly believe in something, you stand behind it. I grew up the youngest of four girls to a single dad who was emotionally vacant, worked, basically. And for those of you who have ever watched my presentation, you may have seen my house. It's not the most attractive house that I used to live in. But I was embarrassed as a girl socially to be able to bring people to that house that was just so dilapidated. It was embarrassing. And being the youngest, you know, I'm always the one that was shooed away. All my three elder sisters were always like the hottest Jones girls. That's my maiden name is Jones. And I was the one that was never picked for teams because I was just the youngest one. Even though my sister Dawn, my second one, had glasses that were those dorky glasses back then, she still was picked. So I always had that last child syndrome. And then going into school, I wasn't the richest. We were one of the poorest. I didn't have all the cool Gap and Benetton or even a Cabbage Patch Kid. I didn't have that stuff. And it's embarrassing because, I mean, for those of you who have kids, you know the pressures that they're put under when they're in school. And so trying to be friends and make friends with the rich kids, you're constantly being alienated. So I didn't have much of a confidence because I was trying to constantly be funny, be friendly, to always, you know, be part of a group. That's how we constantly kept feeling, because I didn't have the backing behind me because of my situation. Because of my situation that I was born in. We can't change that. So I let that run my beliefs. I let where I came from, what I have or don't have, is my worth, is my value. So I really didn't find or start to become confident in me and knowing who I was until I found something that I was really passionate about. So everything that I really became passionate about, I just dove in 100%. And in high school, for me, that was cheerleading. I loved cheerleading, competition cheerleading, not just rah-rah on the sideline cheerleading. So that's what I first got involved with. And I went in head first. As much as you can be head first. When you dive in head first because you're super passionate, that's when you become successful. And in everything else in my path, I'm strongly confident and successful in what I'm passionate about. Everything I'm choosing. We stand here thinking, you know, this is who I am. This is who I am. Oh, I don't have the best upline coach. I don't have the best training. I'm not part of that group. I don't know. Oh, I live in a remote area. It doesn't matter where you are, who you know. It's a matter of how much are you willing to get out there. That's really what it is. How much are you willing to get out there and talk to people and really make a difference? So if you want to keep standing on that ledge, you're going to keep standing on that ledge. Your choice to go, you just got to go and do it, own it, feel it, feel confident in it. This builds joy. It really does. If you own it. So you got to take that leap of faith.